Well, first up on the show, speaking at WION's Global Summit in Dubai, Ram Madhav has slammed the country's commenting on India's internal issues, saying that Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India and will remain so. Listen in.
Hypocrisy should not become the hallmark in criticizing us. People trying to throw stones should remember that they are sitting in glass houses. Let Turkey understand our country is criticizing or questioning our stand in Kashmir, understand that as Air Chief Marshal pointed out, Jammu and Kashmir is an integral part of India. What we do there is a question between our government and people of Jammu and Kashmir, not the business of anybody else. And I also want to remind the world that the Kashmir, which is under illegal occupation of Pakistan, was split into two in 60s. Its status was altered in 60s. Why nobody raised any question about it? So the point is not about tit for tat diplomacy. It's about hypocrisy of the nations that are raising questions over the internal matters of our country. No self-respecting nation would allow other countries to meddle in the internal affairs of its own. Jammu and Kashmir is our own internal affair. We know how to handle it. Our only touchstone is that people of Jammu and Kashmir, they should be happy, they should be satisfied, they should see development reaching their doorsteps. On that, we are fully committed. Situation in Jammu and Kashmir has been projected outside by certain interested sections. Anarchist liberals, you know, the funny situation that we are facing today is the radical liberals don't even have faith in democratic institutions anymore. Their faith now is in anarchy. They propagate as though Jammu Kashmir is a conflict zone. The word that, the phrase that is used all the time is, it's a conflict zone. Let me tell the audience here, most of those Indians know about it. The Kashmir Valley, which has seen terrorism in last 3 decades, courtesy our neighbor, constitutes 3 parliament seats in India's 542 strong parliament house. It constitutes 3 parliament seats. Out of the 3 parliament seat areas, 2 parliament seat areas in Kashmir Valley have largely been always peaceful. There is 1 parliament seat area comprising 3 districts which has seen terror incidents successively. Now, what is the projection globally? That huge militarization is happening. Huge conflict zone has been created. This false narrative about Kashmir, which the Kashmiris do not approve of. Friends, 8 months have passed since we have abrogated Article 370. Not a single major violent incident in Kashmir Valley today. People of Kashmir Valley have largely approved of the measures that the government has taken. We are committed to their welfare. But since propaganda is going on, we offered to our friends, the international friends, if you want to come and see, please go and see it for yourself. Yourselves. Look at what is there in the ground situation. We have nothing to hide. You should be praising our move rather than finding fault with it. And they have gone, and ambassadors came back and told me, so we are surprised. We have encountered traffic jams in Srinagar city. That is the reality on the ground in Jammu and Kashmir today. Life is absolutely normal. Internet has also been restored yesterday. Life is normal. 5-6 leaders are still in detention. they will also be let off. I mean, we don't have any intention to keep leaders behind bars for a very long time. Like in the past, they will be let off. But let me tell you, that they should be let off is not the demand coming from the people of Jammu and Kashmir. Nobody is asking us. Nobody is asking us to set them free. But that is an internal matter I don't want to discuss, only to reassure you that no question of any human rights violations, full political freedom also will be given. Already it is there, but those who are in detention will also be freed sooner than later.